This is Mark Rushton of markrushton.com. Welcome back to my podcast, Original and Live Ambient and Electronic Music. This is podcast number 104, released on September 5, 2016. This podcast is going to be about my contribution to the 244th Disquiet.com Junto, a portion of which you're currently listening to underneath my voice. What is the Disquiet Junto? Well, it's coordinated every week by Mark Wiedenbaum of Disquiet.com since early 2012. The purpose of the group is to use constraints to stoke creativity for audio projects. Artists and musicians can contribute to projects as they wish. They don't have to do it every week. The 244th Junto's assignment was combine tracks from three different European net labels, one from Portugal, Spain, and Switzerland, into one sonic union. Okay, we'll come back to my piece in a few minutes, but first I want you to hear the sounds I used. Okay, the project steps. Step one, this week's project is a remix. The following three tracks are available for creative reuse thanks to a Creative Commons license. Please download them and extract the specified source segments. Okay, you'll get to hear them here in just a second. Use the first 20 seconds of The Station and The Underclass, performed by the Phonetic Orchestra, released on the nsub net label based in Geneva. Okay, the first 10 seconds are quiet, so I'm talking over them. And here it is. Okay, next part is... Okay, the next sample, use the first 20 seconds of Cloud Scissors, composed and performed by a whole list of people, released on the Impulsive Habitat Net label based in Portugal. And here's that 20 seconds. And finally, use the first 20 seconds of Zerazra, or whatever, I can't pronounce it, Z-R-A-E-R-Z-A, performed by a couple of people on the Alge A net label based in, I don't even know how to pronounce that, Galicia. Anyway, here's the 20 seconds. I've turned the volume way, way down so your ears don't bleed. So you heard what I had to work with. Step two, create an original piece of music based on the source audio from those three samples, which I did. I loaded up the edits into Sampler, which is an iOS-based app, and worked my magic. The suggestion was that the track should be about 3 minutes long, and I did that, and I published that track to YouTube. But for this podcast, I've extended things out a bit and made a 10-minute version. So here we go. Thanks for listening, and here it begins.